Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to dictate a transcription of 80 words per minute. Get ready, 10 seconds, 5 seconds, start. Possession or sale of obscene books means in case of possession or sale of obscene books, the ordinary guilty intention will be required before the offense can be said to be complete. The offender must have actually sold or kept for sale the offending article. The circumstances of the case will determine the criminal intent, and it will be a matter of proper interference from them. The argument that the prosecution must give positive evidence to establish a guilty intention involves a supposition that means must always be established by the prosecution through positive evidence. In criminal prosecution, means the prosecution through positive evidence. In criminal prosecution, means necessarily be proved by circumstantial evidence alone unless the accused confess. The echo section makes sale and take place. The appellant is a bookseller. The necessary inference is readily drawn, at least in this case, bookseller. The necessary inference is readily drawn, at least in this case. Difficulties may, however, arise in cases close to the border. To escape difficulty, the appellant can prove his lack of knowledge unless the circumstances are such that he must be held guilty for the acts of another. The court will presume that he is guilty if the book is sold on his behalf and is later found to be obscene unless he can establish that the sale was without his knowledge to be obscene. The law against obscenity has always imposed the prosecution need not prove that the person who sells or keeps for sale any obscene object knows that it is obscene. That first subsection of negligence does not make knowledge of obscenity an ingredient of the offense. The prosecution need not prove something which the law does not and required the prosecution to prove. It would place an almost impenetrable defense in the hands of offenders, something much less than evidence of the offender's knowledge of the obscenity of the book, etc., has made the liability strict. Absence of such knowledge may be taken in mitigation, but it does not take the case out of the subsection. In Quinn, the test of obscenity is this: whether the tendency of the matter charged as obscenity is to deprave and corrupt. Those who minds are open to such immoral influences, and in its whose hands a publication of this sort may fall, it is quite certain that it would suggest to the minds of the young of the entire sex, or even to persons of more advanced years, thoughts of a impure and litigious character. This test has been unfortunately applied in India. It makes the court the judge of obscenity in relation to an impugnant book, etc., and lays emphasis on the potentiality of the impugnant object to deprave and corrupt by immoral influences. The important question is whether this test of obscenity square with the freedom of speech and expression guaranteed in our constitution, or it needs to be modified, and if so, in what respects. The first of these questions invites that court to reach a decision on constitutional issue of a most far-reaching character, and we must beware that we may not lean too far away from the guaranteed freedom. The laying down of the true test is not regarded any the easier because art has varied the true faces, and such individualist appeals that in the same object the facts and the sees only obscenity because his attention is arrested, not by the general or artistic appeal or message which he cannot comprehend, but by general or artistic appeal, and the intellectual sees beauty and art, but nothing gross. The Indian Penal Code does not define the word obscene, and this delicate, the Indian Penal Code distinguishes between that which is artistic and that which is task of how to distinguish between the which is artistic and that which obscene has to be performed by the courts, and in the last resort by us. Admit of a just application from case by indicating a line of democracy, not necessarily sharp, but sufficiently distinct to distinguish between that which is obscene and that which is not. None has so far attempted a definite of obscenity becomes the meaning can be laid bare without attempting a definition by describing what must be looked for. It may, however, be said at once that treating with sex and nudity in art and literature cannot be regarded as evidence of obscenity without something more. If you like this video, please click on subscribe button and also like button.